In this illustration, we'll discuss about the mean kinetic energy of a hanging rod and SHM. We are given that a thin uniform rod of mass M and length L performs a small oscillations about a horizontal axis passing through its upper end. And we are going to find the mean kinetic energy of rod during its oscillation period if at t equal to 0 it is deflected from vertical by an angle theta naught and imparted an angular speed omega naught. So this is a case of angular SHM in which the rod is oscillating like a compound pendulum. Here, see, this is the rod given to us, and if it is deflected from vertical by an angle theta naught and imparted an angular speed omega naught, that means its angular amplitude is more than theta naught. So we can easily calculate it. Here we can first calculate the angular frequency of compound pendulum as omega is equals to root of mgl over I. Here the distance of center of mass of rod, as we consider rod is uniform, will be L by 2. So we can put it as mg, this L by 2 divided by the moment of inertia about the side axis of rotation, we can write as ml square by 3. So here the value of angular frequency we are getting is root of 3g by 2l. So this is the angular frequency with which the rod is oscillating. Here we can also write if beta is the angular amplitude of rod, we use the relation of d theta by dt is equals to omega root of beta square minus theta naught square, where d theta by dt is the angular speed when it is at a position theta naught, and this is given to us as omega naught. So here if we substitute the values, you can see this gives us omega naught is equals to the value of omega we are having, we already calculated as 3g by 2l multiplied by root of beta square minus theta naught square. Or further simplifying, squaring this expression, we'll get the value of angular amplitude beta, which is equals to root of 2l omega naught square by 3g plus theta naught square. So if this is the value of angular amplitude, we can directly write down the mean kinetic energy of angular SHM. This can be written as mean kinetic energy, we can simply write as 1 by 4 I omega square beta square. It is synonymous with the linear SHM, where we write mean kinetic energy as 1 by 4 m omega square a square. So here in angular motion, we replace m by I and amplitude a by angular amplitude beta. This we already studied in concept videos, so directly I am using the result. So this is given as 1 by 4. Moment of inertia we can write as ml square by 3. Multiplied by omega we can write as 3g by 2l. And beta we can write, already we have calculated, so it is 2L omega naught square by 3G plus theta naught square. And from here the value after simplification we are getting is 1 by 8 MGL multiplied by, if we write the value of beta, so this is giving us 2L omega naught square by 3G plus theta naught square. That will be the final result of this problem.